got music in my room, isn't it?
Do you know what? I just put anything on. I used to listen to like rap and all that.
Yeah.
But now I just go with the flow, really.
Yeah.
Pick
anything.
A song. Yeah. Do you know what, actually? Joel Perreault's got me onto like the, I don't know what type of music it is, but it's like, basically it just chills, the way it chills me out.
Yeah.
Like, it's just like, the beats, I'll put a song on now.
Okay.
You heard this?
I think so.
But this is the sort of music he listens to. And obviously where he's from Holland, I think like he's had a bunch of people listen to this sort of music.
So how have you found living in Swansea?
Love it.
Like it?
Mm. Apart from the traffic lights.
Yeah.
Get rid of traffic lights. Let's go.
Have you been to many of the beaches yet?
No.
No?
I'm going to one later today actually with a missus.
Are you? Which one?
Don't know. She said she'd see one on Instagram, so we're going to go.
So what's your usual morning routine?
Morning routine? What? When I wake up or when I'm in the training ground?
When you wake up.
I get up, what time do I get up? I get up about 7.
Yeah.
I have a little hot drink. I'll read like whatever book I'm reading for about half an hour. Yeah. A lot of people don't expect that.
No.
To be honest. But yeah, I'll read like whatever book I'm reading for about half an hour. Make myself some porridge. Eat that. And then once I've had that, I have some berries.
Yeah.
That's me really. Have a shower, get dressed.
What book are you reading at the minute?
I am reading, it's Jay Shea, this is my dad's book actually.
Yeah.
I think it's a thing like a monk or something. Someone's there with like a monk.
Really?
Yeah, I was only a skinhead like yesterday.
Come on, I'll see you.
I definitely wouldn't. But no, it's really good to be fair. It's really good. I'm like into that kind of stuff.
You know like the library in Fairwood? Have you read many of them that book? I say library, the bookcase.
Oh, I have. I think I've got two. I need to return them actually.
Read quite a lot?
Mm. I didn't used to.
Yeah.
I've sort of got a routine of doing it now.
That's good.
Because I've always liked reading, but like it's hard to find the time. Like obviously everyone's lives are so busy now.
Yeah.
You don't really dedicate like half hour of your life to reading. But I thought I actually want to do it. So I've got a routine of in the morning now. I literally just half hour, boom, get it done. And it sort of just chills me out. Like that's why I really like the spiritual books and that.
Yeah.
It chills me out in the morning and it just gets me in like a good mind frame, I suppose.
Good.
So yeah, I'll sort of stick to that.
This is like from countryside.
Yeah, I don't know, I love this.
I like it.
I love this.
Only sheep around.
Yeah, that was a big surprise, yeah.
Was it?
Mm. I think on one of my first days I drove down here and there was sheep walking on the road.
Yeah.
And I thought like, what is going on? Like, is this normal? But everyone else was just like, chilled out. And I was literally looking around like, what's going on?
Yeah, cows up there as well.
Oh, I've seen them.
Yeah.
Cool. Big ones with the horns.
Yeah.
They're right in the car.
I'm quite scared of them ones.
Yes, I'm right to be honest.
I think you're the first in.
I am. It's got to be like it.
You're always the first in.
Me and Grimesy.
Yeah?
Yeah, usually.
It's probably my fault being early as well, sorry.
Yeah, you was a little bit earlier.
Yeah.
Usually I'm in about 10 minutes.
Right. My fault.
That's right. The early bird catches the worm.
Exactly.
As they say.
So do you have breakfast here now? Or have you had yours?
So I've had basically mine, but like I might go up, just chat with the boys, and then I'll have like a little bit of fruit, maybe. Right, let's go. Bad news.
What's
that? So I was just reading on the website you sent me.
Yeah.
You know, to be a monk, you're not allowed to be in a relationship.
What's your choice going to be?
Missus could be fuming at us.
Hey, life. Let's see if you really trap.
So wild.
Come on, Jay.
Thank you.
Get that on.
They're the life of Finley. Oh my, I'm done, seriously. Oh my god.
People are going to be on their best behaviors right now, aren't you? Wait till you see him, Carl.
Ow.
Oh, yeah. Oh my god, he's had a trim. He's had his trim for the team.
I was getting a trim anyway.
You can show
him
how to tip your fingers next.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Because
they're that tip.
Oh, I need to tape my shoe.
Huh?
Oh,
my shoe. I need a knife.
Oh, that's it.
Have a look.
Down a little. I'll walk back in again and do a pan in the gym and I'll just be in here.
Hang on. He's had a trim for it as well.
Now you need to walk in and do a pan of the gym so that.
Yeah, sorry.
Honestly, this is the first time he's been in the gym.
Yeah, look at the boys. The usual.
What are you doing, Ronan?
Just. Has to get gymmed on early in the morning.
Right,
you done?
That's alright. Right, look at the ball.
Look at the
ball. No, not that far out there.
What, on the whiteboard?
Yeah. That's the thing, what are you going to do today? Because normally you just go home.
I know, mate.
So yeah, what are
you
going to do?
It's
kind of like the
training
day. For a day in the life of the
training
day? Yeah, so it's not actually when I get home.
Oh, right, that's
alright
then.
Yeah.
He's had a trim
for
months.
No. I know, I actually haven't. Right, yeah,
dude.
I'm tight today. So tight.
Tough one like yesterday, man.
That's what I mean.
Yeah. And I think that makes us the core yesterday.
So what's the session like today? It's going to be a tough one, like really.
What one do you want?
Oh my mate, you ain't been in this gym.
Why are you Wait, you're normally in your seat, sitting next to Joe.
What's up, Mikey?
Briggs.
Growing Friday, isn't it?
Big Kev,
we all know this. I mean,
Kevin, the growing.
I didn't have an idea.
Morning, lads. Right, coming in, let's do it. A couple of bits from training for us to go over. So yesterday we showed you some stuff out of possession. There's a couple of bits out of possession here, mostly in possession and how you worked yesterday, but just some bits to refresh and to top up on out of possession.
Hey lads, just 3 minutes of West Brom in possession. So really direct, from restarts especially, from Tuesday as you'd expect, just set back. Towards Cowley, get numbers in around him. Forward runs, must protect the space and recover. Like we showed with getting stuck in, don't get stuck in there against him, especially. Okay?
Right, let's train well again. Let's go.
Oh, we've done that?
Done it in the game. Done it in the Bristol City game.
Yeah?
I don't know how I did it, but like, I think my hand was hurting, like, in the first half.
Yeah. And then the extra in the
picture. Crack down it.
How long you in that for?
I think 4 weeks.
You could play with that, wouldn't you? Yeah.
Yeah.
How was it filming on day in the life of Flynn?
Good, mate.
Nah.
Trying to find things to do.
Oh! Well done, mate. Really well done.
Yeah,
cheers.
Is that you?
Oh, cheers, mate.
Yeah. Bring a one-handed bat to everyone with them.
Right, cheers, Luggy.
Top man, cheers, Freddy. Appreciate it, mate.
Behind the lines, good, push through!
Ready, step forward.
Yeah, please.
Hold on. Run the pack, hold on. away.
Show line, Grimesy, yeah, show line.
Keep left.
Ready? Yeah. Show line,
Nelly. Well played, Grimesy and Olix. Here now, Mikey, tell him. Oh, he's having a brilliant play for you.
Finish, Cap.
Oh, yeah. Who's
Sorry. Good as new.
Did you get it on film that you didn't clean the sink after?
Whoa. You didn't get the before though. You didn't get the before and after.
Mate! Three cheers for the stiffs, wasn't it?
What?
Three cheers for the BT. BT and when player of the tournament. It's a travesty.
How you doing, Jim?
Yeah,
mate. Never seen you here before, mate. Camera must be on you. Yeah. Well done, mate.
Normal four exercises for us, the drop to laterals, the two purple bands.
The normal four, mate, you haven't finished.
Mate, no, he's part of the power and core club, that, ain't he?
Yeah, I can tell. Wow, yeah, that was powerful.
What are you doing?
I can't
interview. That's it,
yeah.
That's
right,
isn't it?
Yeah, that feels like years ago.
It does.
No, I love
that's
it.
That's good though.
Yeah.
Because it feels like, I don't know, just partly furniture.
That's what I'm wearing, yeah. But then, like, I think that's like testament to the club, the staff, like everyone around here. Like, it's got like that family feel about it.
Yeah.
Like, even the whole place, like everyone around it, like, I remember walking down the street and someone being like, oh, you're my favourite player, like, stuff like that. It doesn't,
yeah.
That doesn't happen like everywhere, do you know what I mean?
And I think what I've noticed, do you know when we play other teams, like we were playing Huddersfield and one of the players said he lives in Leeds, but in Swansea, all the boys live in Swansea. So like, say like on your days off and stuff, like you see the boys and it adds to that community.
Big time.
It's good though, I like
them. Yeah, so do I. I think it brings you together as well, like your togetherness. Because I think like on days off, a lot of other clubs, they just, everyone goes separate ways. Like here, you bump into everyone, like we'll be going for a coffee and I'll see the other boys and their girlfriends. Like it's so good. It's so good.
Was it Bristol City game when it was pouring down?
Yeah, pouring down, yeah. I like that.
Do you like it?
But it's just when it gets cold. If it's raining and it's not cold, it's perfect. But if your big tackles in, it's perfect.
A night game. Do you like?
I'm not a
fan. What would you prefer? Just
day games, yeah. Because the thing is, with a night game, you're just waiting around all day.
Yeah.
And like, you can't really do nothing because you're waiting for the game. So I'm not really a fan. But
do you know, like, say 12:30 kick off?
Yeah.
I always think then, like, that's messing with your pre-match.
It is. Oh, Cardiff game.
Oh.
Waking up at, oh, we had a mare, didn't we? Cardiff game.
What?
Because all the roads were blocked, weren't they?
Oh, it was the half marathon.
So we had, literally had to get up at like 7 and walk out. We had to walk down to, you know where Rosoy is?
Yeah.
Over the bridge. We had to walk, so obviously there was a few of us. We literally had to walk there at like 7 in the morning.
And you have all these people out for half marathon.
Yeah. All running and then, then we'd get, I don't know what time we got to the, ground.
So that was like 5 hours before.
Yeah. And then we were trying to eat. Oh, honestly. Yeah, that's a bit too early for me.
Yeah.
Oh, what a day.
Well, thank you. We'll stop stalking you now.
Lovely.
And we hope people know what it's like to be Flynn Downes.
Oh, yeah. It's not glitz and glamour, I'll tell you that.